Success And may God
culminate your endeavors with all that is useful and beneficial to your club
and your district.
Thank you.
Clear?
Yes.
Yes.
I said now to Mother Maya, through this talk, one rank is 1,028 and another 1,009. And one like Tatar is 2 for Mother Papa, that's the cancer. That means 1,000.
One moment, please. I get your microphone.
Abdulaziz, actually, what we had is we have advertising. Instead of putting them in the income, and you see that the, you will see here the net cost of the magazine. It is the same. If you look at item number 2-1 in the expenses, you will find at the last line of it, less the advertising revenues, $38,400. So this the 14,000 800 is the cost net. So it's, both of them are identical, but the other presentation would show the clubs that actually what is spent by the clubs to the magazine is only $14,000. So it is the same. Okay. Yes, but the net result as a total budget, it became $90,000 instead of $128.6. I want to ask concerning the magazine. It is income, but it doesn't show income. It's a part of the.
I've answered you, sir.
What we have done is we give you the 13,000, which is the net cost. It is the cost minus the advertising equal 14,000. So it is to be clear to all the members in the district 2450 that we are only paying $14,000 for the magazine, not 100. And so it's the same. If you add the 38,000 to the 90,000, it will give you back the 138.
Okay, then this is the final.
Any more questions? Thank you. Item number 3.
Just a second, please.
Item number 3 is the COL, which requires that we give our votes or our ideas to the 427 legislations. We sent volume 1 and volume 2 to most of the clubs, and we should give a reply by the 13th of June 2004. Whether we give our vote or our opinions or not, the Rotary International will come out with it, but it is very essential that we should say, and each one of us in the club should say his opinion and his what he thinks about it. So we have until June 13, 2004, unless you agree on the points that were given, and we can vote for them now. And if not, we will adopt the resolution that we will send the answers to Mr. Hazem Finch, first district governor, and a CC to district governor Sami Sarkar. Any questions?
Shall we vote or not?
Okay. Go ahead. Okay. The district policy manual. The idea of a district policy manual was brought up last year, and we had a lot of debates and a lot of talk among us, and we came out with a plan which aims to the following. First of all, decentralization. Second, administration. Third, finance. Fourth, communication. And then procedures. There was a lack of communication that some of the clubs did not receive all the documents, and some of the clubs had some remarks on it. So in this General Assembly, we would like to vote and to adopt the principle. First of all, do you agree that we have a district policy manual or not?
Yes.
This is the first vote.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Okay. If please, those who agree to have a district policy manual for the district, raise their hands.
District policy manual, yes.
In principle.
Okay. So it is a majority.
We didn't receive anything about it.
No, he was saying.
We'd like to have more details. What is the purpose of this?
Read it.
We didn't have time to read it. So don't vote without this.
What will happen?
Please, if you will give us a little time to read what is written here. We didn't receive anything concerning this matter.
I want. Okay.
If you may, before we vote. Thank you.
What's on it is nothing, it's just the procedure that I will speak about later, if you agree.
Agree or not? First of all, you agree or not?
What is the purpose of having a district procedure manual which is different from the manual that we received from Rotary International?
The district procedure manual will be within the frame of the manual of procedure of the Rotary International. We are not going to invent it. We're going to adapt what's good for us, put it in, and to become a district procedure manual. Okay, so as you all said, you agreed to it. This is what we'll do with your approval. First of all, we have a committee review headed by myself, and a committee that I will choose with people who have the time and are willing to give us the time to sit down and just go through it line by line again. And this, it will be finished by August. This will be done by end of June.
It's too short time.
June?
So we have to have 6 months.
Okay. December 2000. Okay. Then after they approved what they do, and committee will submit final draft, which is DG and Kusanan. Okay. As I said, since you approved it in principle, then I will form a committee headed by myself, and we will go through this again, and then we shall submit it again to the clubs to be reviewed again. And then we'll give them a time frame to send us any remarks. And then we will see all the remarks again and re-review it. And then send a final copy to the clubs again with a time frame that they have to say answer. If not, I will take it for granted that they have agreed. And by that, we will have our own district project manual. Is this acceptable to you?
Yes.
Okay, we come to the 07-08 nominating committee. the district project manual, there will be a procedure that if you all agree to it according to this manual, then it will prevent us from going into this again. But since the district manual procedure not adopted, then as the bylaw states that the incoming district governor nominates a committee to choose the 0708 governor. And I have chosen the names. First of all, past district governor Hazem Finch Sherman, past district governor Inyas Muawad, past president Bashir Zouk, Mr. Nadeem Karash, Nuhad Nofel, Mario Nadar, and Kamil Minasa. Do you approve?
I would like to know how do you choose this name, please, Mr. How did you
choose the name? I'm Roger Terassi, incoming president of the Rotary Club of Beirut. Wanted to ask what's the selection criteria of the members of the committee. Thank you.
It's my own choice. At the bylaw states that I have the right to choose the nominating committee. To explain more, in the bylaws, very clear. Kalubo, please. To explain clearly the bylaws, if the General Assembly does not agree to the names of the nominating committee, then the committee will be by law the last five past district governors.
Is G. Hazem Finch was asked today? No, because Billy G. Hazem Finch mentioned that he refuses to be a member of the committee, so we want to make sure that he will be the chairman of the committee. He says to me and to other presidents, he will not act on this committee. Would you kindly make sure he is going to be a member, otherwise the whole committee is completely disrupted. Thank you.
Sure. Mr. Hazem Finch here?
Yes.
Please, Kamil Nassa is our friend from Rotary Club of Beirut. But really, we never seen him in the club. I don't know how his name is in this nominating committee.
Thank you.
if you don't mind. I see your answer. Would you give me a second, please? You give me 2 seconds. Thank you very much. Let me elaborate on the procedure stipulated in the manual of procedure. The manual of procedure states that the district governor suggests the names of the nominating committee to nominate a district governor. Those names and the committee should be adopted, and it's only the privilege of your assembly to have the legal status of this committee. It is your privilege. But if this assembly failed today to name those committee, then by the bylaw, it is the last 5 PDGs will consist of this committee. In the district. So what we need to do now, the incoming governor tried. Yes, Camille maybe is not active member, but he is a prominent Rotarian who is respected by all of you in Lebanon, and we need in this committee, first, that it is prominent figures, non-biased to any. We don't know who are the nominees yet. They could be anybody. We're trying to have a selection of balanced, prominent figures. If you don't agree, we are going to vote, and please don't agree or agree. It's your privilege. There is no anybody trying to impose anybody. So it is your choice. The other choice, if you like, that the incoming district governor can name 10 names, and you pick 5 or 7 out of them, and we do a sort of a selection. But this is not something which is respectable, because who's better than whom? It has nothing to do with that. So let's look at it from a broader point of view. Secondly, all this will be subject to a main clause in the district policy manual. Gladys said, why do we need a district policy manual? We need a district policy manual to stipulate all our traditions in District 2450, to do all our procedures written. So it's not a tradition. There is nothing against the bylaws. There is nothing will be conflicting to the bylaws. So until we have this district policy manual by next year, we need to establish something which is according to the bylaws.
But
yes?
As far as concerning this matter, as I know, in Rotary there are no boundaries, and we are on the...
We are selecting the committee.
No, I'm talking about what you have mentioned.
I agree.
For the manual, district manual.
I agree.
So Rotary has no boundaries.
We didn't say
international. So why we need to adopt the international Rotary manual to our tradition? It is international. It is on all international scene that we have the same principles of Rotary, as far as I understand.
Most of the districts all over the world have what they call district bylaws or district
policy
manuals. That's not a tradition which we are inventing. 80% of the districts worldwide are adapting their own policy manual or their district bylaws. I have in my bag here, for an instance, District 5060 is adapting its own manual, and they have it. It's everywhere. It's not something being invented. It is something actually advised from Rotary International.
Please do. Excuse me. My name is Sharam Shaykh. I fully agree. We fully agree with the manual, and I will come back to the manual later on. Now, I am going to give my view on the matter of the nominating committee. I said it earlier, and I will repeat it now with emphasis, because we want to protect this district and we don't want to create problems where there are not. It is natural and reasonable and within the character of every human being that if now you nominate those people, we will start a turmoil in Lebanon. I propose that the decision is taken that the government will appoint a nominating committee, which is by the manual. And by the way, whatever we apply by gentlemen's agreement in this district is very valid and approved by Rotary International. If we didn't have our gentlemen's agreement, and if we don't have a manual eventually, the district cannot be run. Whereas, if we do it right, we can have even a larger district and be run efficiently. But with this, my suggestion originally made, please accept that the governor, in time and in cooperation with his people in Lebanon, will select and appoint the 7 people in due time before the election begins. If you nominate now names, you will have this reaction and it will be a turmoil and a snowball, which will not bring good results. Lobbying will start and automatically the election in Lebanon will be a havoc. So we say yes to the right of the governor to appoint the nominating committee, and it is up to the governor, in cooperation with his Lebanese advisors and friends, to make this nomination at the time of his choice, so that all these things will be avoided. Thank you.
With all the respect to what our past the governor's Doris has mentioned, and with the agreement to most of what he has said, but please let me point out that if we are not able to agree on a nominating committee in this assembly, the only alternative, if we are going to follow the manual procedure, is that the committee will be formed of the last past, this 5 past district governors. So if we are not able to take a decision today, then this is a failure and we have to go to the procedure by the manual procedure. Yes. You cannot postpone the choice, the nominating committee after the district. This is by the manual procedure.
May I just say one thing? If the General Assembly agrees on what past district governor Doros said, if, then the decision has to be taken in this General Assembly that gives me the full authority to put the 5 names, and what I put will be not debatable.
But after consultation with Lebanese,
I'm just explaining, I'm not saying I want it, I'm just explaining, because we have to leave here with a decision whether that we nominate the names or I have the power of the General Assembly to put the names. Go ahead.
We agree, but after consultation with all people concerned in Lebanon, the 18 clubs in Lebanon, okay?
Joseph Malouf, President Rotary Club Zahid A. I think we have a number of issues on the agenda, and this is one of them. I'd like just a little clarification from past district governor. When you said the incoming district governor can suggest 10 names that 10 people will choose from, is that stipulated?
No. What we're saying is we thought of a lot of procedure this morning of how to apply. We can give names, but this will create chaos. So I was just explaining what happened. But what is stipulated is that the district governor suggests nomination to the district conference votes for it, and then it is adopted. This is what, and if the conference fails, it goes to the class 5 became.
We're obviously under the laws and procedures, constitution of Rotary, etc., and we respect all of that. At the same time, I'd like to make a suggestion that might address what the past District Governor Doro said, which is to preserve a little bit the harmony of the dialogue and the cooperation that we've been able to have as the 18 Lebanese clubs in Lebanon. We're acting as one body, even though we're 18 different elements or subsystems of this one body. I'd like to suggest that if it is possible to move on to another topic and give the proxy to people from the Lebanese clubs a few minutes, 15 minutes, half an hour, and we will just get back to you within the half hour with a couple of suggestions if that's possible.
Joseph, yes. Joseph, I'm sorry you are putting us in another turmoil, which I didn't want we go in from the beginning. Just a second, please. You told me that you will give the proxies of the Lebanese. I never said that the elections are from Lebanon. I said that this is the nominating committee of 07-08. I didn't say it's from Lebanon. I didn't say that the voters are. So please, we are trying to go by the bylaws. The nominating committee consists of seven, by coincidence, they are Lebanese.
All I'm saying, Pastor District Governor, is in the spirit of what Rotary is about, we aspire in RILAS and other programs to teach our youth proper leadership, etc. And I'm sure you all believe in democratic processes. Under the laws that you're suggesting, and we abide to these laws, procedures, processes, all I was suggesting is simply an opportunity to preserve the harmony that past District Governor Doros alluded to, with all due respect, and I rest my case.
Thank you, Joe.
We authorize, Governor.
As I said, and I explained,
good morning, everybody. First of all, I have to talk something about the district policy manual. Gladys was saying that we have the manual of procedure. If you go through the manual of procedure, even in the club, even in the district, you see that Rotary is not putting only something that we have to fit. There is a lot of alternatives that they are putting. When we put a manual of district policy, so we have to follow. But taking this into consideration, the Rotary International stipulated that the governor has the right to nominate the nominating committee. If not, it will go to the 5-party governor. So in the manual of procedure that we are going to put, the policy that we are going to put is that we are going every year to elect the nominating committee in our district. That's for one. The second thing, that we are not accustomed that the governor is going and asking all the members in the district conference or district assembly about the name he is going to nominate. Really, it's something that Munir Sabat is doing for the first time, and we have to thank him that he returned to us, because every year we have been advised by the governor about the name of the nominating committee, as it was every year like this. So it's the first time in the district that a district, incoming district governor, came to us and asked the floor about a right that he has in Rotary since the year 28 in our district. So about the name that he is suggesting, I don't think anyone from the Lebanese can say that any one of these three persons is not a good person in Lebanon, a good Rotarian. Perhaps for some reasons he is not coming to the clubs, but they are. They know very well the people, and they know very well everyone. I cannot say to Munir Sabat, you are putting names there. Be sure that I am not the one who put the names. I put some names, perhaps he asked a lot of us about some names. He know a lot of people, but after all, anyone who will be in this committee will try to do the best for Lebanon and the best for our district. Thank you.
Okay.
So after we hear our Lebanese friend, we come. We have now the two alternatives. First alternative, Munir, you want to say something?
Yes, please.
Microphone here, please.
Good morning, my dear fellow Rotarians. I'm sorry to have all this time on this subject, but it is very simple and we don't want to complicate the matters. Of course, we appreciate the step of our incoming governor to ask our advice, or to ask your advice, the advice of the clubs and the General Assembly, and to have your idea or to have your approval. But it is very simple. Very, very simple. There is a proposal. If you do not agree, we have to stick to the manual of procedure. The governor has to read or to apply what is in the manual of procedure. We always respect the friends from each country when it comes to the term. We have our friends in the room. They have to sit together and to agree. I'm sorry to pass this to the governor. Hasn't finished, he's not here. I met him outside there. He's very upset and he is refusing to come because he is not happy. You have to sit together with him. He's your eldest past district governor. Try to smooth the matter and come out with a single, with an agreement for that. If we fail today, or you fail to have an approval, the only thing to apply the manual procedure, which states very clearly that the nominating committee will be sent the names from the district governor, the incoming district governor, comprising the last five district governors, past district governor alive, if not three plus the last two or the last three past presidents. So please try to respect our traditions and we shall stick to that, in order not to make more confusion. Thank you.
Any more questions?
Can you explain? Zuhair Jaber from Alay Rotary Club, past president. Can you please explain for us what is the role of this nominated committee? Does it have any effect in selecting the governor? Thank you.
Yes.
The function and the job of the nominating committee is to choose the governor for the year 2006, 2007, 2008. This is the main job of this committee. The procedure that the clubs will send some names and this nominating committee will sit down, will review the name, and if they find a good Rotarian to represent them as the governor, they will do so. And they have the right, this nominating committee has the right to choose any other person, even if not nominated by a club.
Excuse me, sir.
This is the procedure.
Excuse me, sir. That means
just a second, sir. The PDG Rauf Abu Gaber raising his hand first, if you don't mind.
Mike.
I remember the days when we had the friend from Lebanon, yes, our being elected, and we are repeating history today.
If we would waste so much time on just choosing the members nominating committee, you can imagine the differences that will occur when we have the real election meeting. I strongly recommend that this suggestion has the two past governors and has five other members of the Rotary Clubs of Lebanon, and probably this is a representative sample. If for Lebanese politics there are one, two, or three who are not qualified to be in this committee because of either commitments made or outspoken stance, I suggest that you mention one name, two names, three names, and then the incoming district governor will consider changing. But don't fight all the time already on the nominating committee before even the election takes place. Thank you, Mr. Thabit. I think we should go forward and decide on these seven gentlemen. If there's a need to change one or two or three, do it. But let's do it and finish with it. Thank you.
Do I understand, Gary, that you need to vote on the seven?
No.
You want to give the right to change it.
Now, the two past district governors, are a must. I think it's the prestige of this movement, the Rotary, is that the past district governors have always had this balanced, unbiased, and neutral stand. They will definitely seek the benefit of the Rotary movement in Lebanon by choosing an incoming governor. Now, the other five members are, I don't know them all, but I think are all worthy people who can easily complete such a mission. But if the Lebanese, with their knowledge of the local considerations, wish to have one or two or three removed or added to, why not? But now, let's hear a balanced and frank opinion. What do you object to the other five being on the committee just because of local considerations? I'm really speaking to the Lebanese. Well, why are you objecting to the committee?
We are not involved in this.
We are suggesting to you this.
I'd like to respond to that.
Right, we have.
I'd like to respond to that.
Okay. We're not about to analyze anyone's character here. We're not about to vote for any individuals that will be on the nominating committee. What we're suggesting is simple. We truly appreciate the initiative that incoming district governor have taken. At the same time, since there is an event taking place next year of establishing a manual of policy at the level of district, within which I believe there will be a certain procedure for instituting and nominating people for the nominating committee. I hope that this initiative would be blessed and agreed to by the whole assembly today. At the same time, I would like to propose that we go by the manual of procedure and we forego, although it is a wonderful initiative, forego this initiative this year and go back to the five governors, five past district governors, which is going to be a much more harmonious process in the absence of a procedure to the nominating committee.
Just a second. By the way, I just want to clarify one point. We are discussing the 0708 district governor. Actually, we are not obliged to elect him until next year.
I don't know.
So if you want...
Okay, please give me 2 minutes, listen carefully. We have three alternatives to finish this problem. The first alternative is you disagree and we go back to the five district governors in the district. Second option is you, as a General Assembly, give me the full authority and power to nominate the committee. Which changed if you want, because you, this would be understood that you need to change some of the names and I could go back and discuss more and so on. The third opportunity is that we are not obliged to nominate the committee this year because we are thinking about 0708. We can postpone it by the General Assembly decision till the next General Assembly. By that time we would have finished the manual, district manual procedure, and you have all agreed to the district manual procedure, and we will go by it. You have three alternatives.
Number two.
Then we shall vote. We shall vote on the three procedures. The three alternatives. We shall vote on the three choices. First choice, that we postpone it to the next General Assembly. Second choice,
that
you vote, I'm giving you again the three choices. ولا رابع لهم.
في رابع نحن نوافق على ال.
ما فيش رابع.
لا يوافق على ده. نوافق على ده الرابع.
ما هو ده من تحت ما هو ده من ضمن الثلاث.
لا.
Let me explain and then Zora say what you want. The first choice is to postpone. The second choice is to refuse the names and you appoint and give me the full authority to put the committee. And the third, and I forgot that. or we go back to the five districts, the past five.
Do you agree to this?
PDGs.
Please, may I have your attention, please? Here, without seriousness, we are jumping into a whole of mud. Number one, there is a gentleman's agreement which is for many years running in this district, how to elect governors and from which country to elect governors. We respected it, it goes well, and we want to continue for the sake of the district. Now, this guides us to abolish the five past district governors, because nobody in Lebanon, in Cyprus, or in Jordan will want the nominating committee out of that country to conduct the elections in that particular country. Yeah. Therefore, we have decided in the past, and we follow it, that the nominating committee always comes from the district from where the governor will come. From the country, yes. Now, the policy of mentioning names here and asking for a ballot is again wrong, because I am not supposed, being a Cypriot or Tofik Jordanian, to vote for Lebanese. This is what we cherished in this district. The time of Lebanon, the Lebanese will vote. The time of Jordan, the Jordanians will vote. The time of Egypt, the Egyptians will vote. Therefore, my friends, it was not a good idea to have names here and ask us to vote for these names. Now, on the other hand, I want to congratulate Munir for bringing the subject up. But he is covered by the manual already. He has the right, without asking us, at the time of his convenience, to consult with the Lebanese friends, not to go to the clubs, because then it is a double election, but to consult
good people in Lebanon. And the point, the nominating committee, he feels nobody can deny him this right. And this is what I suggest he will do. To postpone is not a good idea, because when Tofik Kawar, when he was governor, started to elect the governors earlier, it's good, because we have people who are well trained, like we have now John Strongylos and Hassan Abbas Helmi and the others. It's good to have them and know them earlier so that they prepare well. So there is only one solution, my friends. Just put your hand in your heart and see. Yes, thank you, Munir, for bringing this up. You have the right. On your choice, whenever you want, in consultation with your friends and consultants in Lebanon, to appoint the nominating committee you wish. You can finish the story.
Thank you, please, it's a point. It's a formal point, please, may I? But please. Well, actually, what has been running here is a very healthy discussion and procedure. Thank you, Doros, for your very good words. And I do suggest the following so that we can follow the procedure and keep on abiding to the rules. We have a voting form in our hands, item of which, number two, is to vote by yes or no or abstain on the point saying, do you approve the names suggested for the district governor's nominating committee for the year 2007-2008? I do suggest that the voting delegates from all clubs outside of Lebanon to vote abstaining from an answer by yes or no, and to give our Lebanese friends the chance to say yes or no. This, by this way, we are not superimposing a name on them. So, okay, if this is an acceptable solution, it will take us a step ahead that today we know if this committee is acceptable to them. You are going to cancel now. What is actually happening here in this assembly is who is voting? The clubs are voting. So the clubs have votes, and each club has its vote according to the manual of procedure. The procedure should take place in a democratic way, and to follow the procedure, the voting delegates should say their opinion, not on this way on the floor. This is an important point if we want to follow the rule. Thank you.
Who's voting?
Come on, at least since we are talking about clubs by state, eventually we may actually have to consider it. Because any comment concerning people on this listing there, they are all in figure, and they are all perfect Rotarians, will be insulting. I would recommend personally, with my two votes, and as a member of the Rotary Club of Lebanon, that we leave you the choice, today and not after 1 year, to go on selecting a committee. If you would like to consult the Lebanese clubs actually present here as a district. Thank you.
Okay, this brings us back to what I said. Okay, first choice, you do not agree.
No postpone.
Those who agree not to postpone, raise their hand.
Not to postpone.
Okay. So, number one down. So we have now two choices. The names or the authorization for the incoming governor to put the names after constructing, but not today. Not today. That's my convenience.
Yes.
Please, those who agree to give me the authorization to nominate the committee,
yes.
at my best time, please raise your hand.
Yes. Bravo.
Okay, the last item now is the Rotary. Some of the votes will be for the clubs, and the last vote is for the incoming president, which is the 2004-2005 budget. Okay, I will ask you just to shorten the time so it won't take more time for you. Do you agree as a General Assembly to have the votes by raising the hands instead of writing it down? Those who agree, raise their hands, please.
Yes, I agree.
Minority, then we'll go by the paper.
Minority.
Thank you. For your information. For your information, the committee that will count the votes are Mr. Hani Hafiz, President Arif. Arif Al-Arif, Amal Hawaila, Nina Saleh, Usama Al-Barghouti. We need the boxes, and we shall start doing the votes. Give to Sanadir Ehani. Yes, sir.
We discussed last night that in line of the problems we have, we are a district of 4,000 people, and in an assembly we have only a few hundred. And eventually, probably, by the manual, we may come to the ballot by mail, or we may come to the point when all the subjects for the agenda have to be sent weeks before, and so that the people can put them before the clubs instead of last minute and all these things. So we are very happy that we adopted today the resolution that the manual will go on. In line of this, I propose, instead of wasting time making elections, whatever, to unanimously give our approval to the proposals as set at the assembly today, in line of the developments for the future. Because whatever we say, it will be minor things plus, or, you know, a little favor or against. So to save time, if the others do not have any objection and there are no no's, to say unanimously by raise of hand the approval to the assembly items and finish the story based on the hope that the future will be better by the introduction of the manual. So my proposal is to say yes and avoid the balloting.
Well, I did ask before that whether we like it by raising the hand, and they refused.
No,
the
you didn't.
No.
Ask it. Ask again.
Okay, ask again. Let the floor agree, instead of putting in the paper, that we agree on each item by raising our hands. Those who agree, please raise their hand.
Yes.
Minority.
Pardon.
If I raise my hand, I'm not accepting.
Let's go by the paper, sir. Okay.
Minority.
Hani. you have the list?
Excuse me, sir.
Sorry, I can't see anything from
you. You cannot do this by show of hands.
Now I see.
Because some people have three votes, some people have one vote.
Yep.
How can I raise three hands?
Nobody is going to say no to anything. They want the vote.
Ladies and gentlemen, the electors, please will go to the back. People with proxies, go to the back. They have to submit their proxies. Others, please stay. We are voting on three items: the 0203 financial statements, the 0405 budget, and the Council on Legislation. I don't think you need to vote. Just send it by mail. Incoming to Master to Governor Hassan.
We have postponed discussions
on the budget. You want to discuss anything, sir? We are not Amra.
The second item, the capital names.
Chief names, yes, we understand. Yes. على 0203 على 0405 هو أكثر الاستشارة الخاصة بكل بودي يعني هما تو ايتمز بس تو ايتمز اللي بدي اعملهم بودي